Hello, welcome back to my project. This is Eric. Today I'm so happy to have a few updates. Finally, the first housing case for the keypad is complete. This was done by my friend Nate, and he's a very good product designer. From what I've heard from him, this keypad cover is the fourth version and has been through a lot of testing to ensure that the buttons working well. The used material is TPU, which is the advanced flexible material. I'm not familiar with this kind of stuff. Anyway, the pressing key is excellent. I feel like the quality of this product has been improved a lot with this one. In addition to this, the entire housing case is also in preparation, so I will update you again as soon as it comes out. Another device is ready next to ESP32Berry. This is WT32SG01. In one of my previous videos, I mentioned the graphics performance of this device. This is using the SPI interface, but it can draw graphics very quickly. You can see how fast it is from my comparison video. But in this project, it's not currently running at the full speed of SPI yet. This looks like it needs more work. As mentioned before, I prepared my ESP32Berry application to run on devices without a physical keyboard. This is also a beta version, and I only tested on the device I currently have. Also, I have to work on this more, it's still unstable. One caveat, all graphics are drawn at 480x320 resolution, so if you have a display with a different resolution, this won't work. Please modify all the graphic widgets for yours. I will show you how it works without a keyboard. Currently, no information is displayed here because the SD card and battery are not connected. Let's connect to Wi-Fi. Everything is the same as before until you enter the password, but instead of using the physical keyboard, you can use the virtual keyboard to enter the required text. When the virtual keyboard appears, a new text area appears at the top of the screen. I made this workaround because the virtual keyboard is covering the selected focus text area. Now let me enter the password. Typing is not easy. A bigger on-screen keyboard would be easier to type on, but it's not that easy on 3.5-inch screen. A Wi-Fi connection will be established. Let's just send and receive messages on Telegram. This is the same version implemented in the previous version 0.2. Typing isn't easy, but you can see it working without any issues at all. Okay, all looks good. The next one is showing a new app. What I'm releasing now is a simple chat app using ESP-NOW. I already made a similar application a long time ago using ESP-NOW and LVGL 7, but in this version, you can dynamically set up peer to connect to. When you open the app, your current MAC address is displayed. You can also enter the other party's MAC address in the pop-up window. Let me enter the MAC address for each. A connection has been made. Now let's send a message to each other. There is a delay in sending messages due to the network connection, but it gets better soon. Since there is a current Wi-Fi connection, it's possible to display the record time at which the message is delivered. ESP-NOW can be used with Wi-Fi, but both devices must use the same Wi-Fi channel for communication. Therefore, both devices have to be on the same Wi-Fi or have to be without a Wi-Fi connection. Okay, all looks good. This is all I have today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.